And then I have very distinct memories of like after the first 2 years of being in Canada, I had this idea of like I want to go back home to Japan.
どうだった？日本に久しぶりにまあ引っ越してきて。
Like smelling the same smells, like that stays with you. Like I'm like all Lawsons smell the same. It kind of was like now I'm here and I'm not exactly Canadian, but I'm not exactly fully Japanese either. And so I think that around this time.Was when like, I was like, oh my god, what am I?
今日は日本とカナダのハーフ、アーロンの人生について話してみるよ。Let's find out! こんにちは、全人ルトトです。ナルトのボーク、ナルトです。
アーロンです。
アーロンです。
ナルト?
Doesn't Ultraman have a move like this?
Does he? Wow.
Does he go like this? I'm pretty sure he does, doesn't he?
I guess that's where Naruto got it from.
Specium course.
So,
wow.
Boom!
What's the story? Today's theme is... Bling! Aaron's life! Yay!
I'm looking forward to looking at this video again so I can see how upset you are.
Oh my god. I'm not used to this much attention. This is crazy. I'm a shy boy.
Yeah, and he's a YouTuber.
Oh my god.
このね、メンバーのこの一人一人についてもっとよく知りたいって声がいつもあるんですよ。でも結構さ、僕らは何か物事について話してることが多いじゃん。だから、一人一人の人生にフォーカスを当てて話をしてみようということで、まあ、アナとね、ポールの動画も上がってると思うんだけど、今日はアロン。話をしたいと思います。で、今日もね、書いてもらいました。人生グラフね。人生グラフ。
人生グラフ。
で、縦がジャパンラブド。まあ、ハーフにジャパンラブドってちょっとよくわからんけど
That's true.
まあ、懐かしいレベルかな。
そうね。でも一応カナダで育ってるから、まあ、そこに関してはなんかちょっと普通の日本人と違う経験をしてるわけよね、
う
ん、きっと、
ね、
だからそういう話を聞きたいなと思って、まあ、この横軸は年齢で、年齢とともにこの日本に対する気持ちがまあどう変わってきたのかっていうのを通じて、まあ、アーロンの今日は人生を聞いていきたいと思いますので、よろしくお願いします。
はい、OK、わかりました。
それでは、行ってみましょう。
頑張ります。Oh my god. Alright, so thank you, Anna, for holding my graph here. I spent a lot of time on it. Isn't it beautiful?
It is.
Thank you.
Okay, so, like most humans, you're 0 years old when you're born.
マジで?
マジか。
話が進まんなよ。
So I was born in Kobe. I was born in Japan. I wasn't born in...
そうだね。実は、
yeah.
日本で生まれてるんよね。
そうそうそうそうそうそう。兵庫県、神戸です。And so I wasn't born in Canada. So me and my oldest sister, we were born in Japan. The other two were born elsewhere. But yeah, I was born in Kobe. And so between 0 and 5 years old, you know, I've just lived a pretty normal Japanese kid's life. You know, I went to Yotien. I felt like a normal Japanese boy, basically. Right?
あ、5歳まで行ったの?
まあ、7歳ね。
あ、7歳まで行ったんだ。
あ、そうそうそう。
おーおーお
ー。So yeah, I spent the first 7 years of my life in Japan for the most part. There was a stint here and there where I went to BC for, or went to Canada for a bit. But for the time I was in Japan, I felt like a normal Japanese boy. The concept of half didn't occur to me.The concept of race, obviously,、mm. you know, who thinks about race when you're 5 years old, right? And so, you know, I was accepted by my neighbors, I was accepted by my school classmates and stuff like that. So there was no concept of me feeling out of place or having any sort of like identity issue or anything like that.
Oh,、
right?
okay, so wait, did you not look like a little white boy when you were a kid?
So I think, as far as I can remember,、I looked more Asian.
あでもなんかそれ聞くかも。ハーフの子は最初アジア人っぽくて変わってくって。
いやいや。
Did you have a ball?
Oh yeah, dude.
Oh, he had a ball cut.
I had the ball. I had it all. Yeah,
that's why.
Yeah, yeah.
何それ?
The ball cut?
You know the ball cut? Where like Asian parents, they put a ball on your head
yeah,
and
yeah.
they cut around the edges、
yeah.
and that's how all Asians get their hair cut.
説明してくれ。
That's the inaugural haircut, yeah.
なるほど。お母さんの方が日本人。
日本人ですね。
で、お父さんの方が
カナダ。
カナダ人。
はい。
で、お父さんの方が白人だよね。
そうですね。
はい。What are you talking Japanese inside the household as well?
そうそう、それ気になる。
母さん、何the heck are you doing in my hair? Did you do that?
No, no.
理解しづら。
何the heck are you doing? お母さん、出ていけ。
出ていけ。Get out, 出ていけ。
I think it was probably good half and half. Like, with my sisters, I would speak English, I think. But with my mom, I would speak Japanese, I think. I don't remember, but I remember like at school, of course, it'd be Japanese. And so I think since my parents had a plan to move us all to Canada, I think they wanted to prepare us all for English. And so I think they tried to have a more English environment in the years leading up to us moving. So,
じゃあもう7歳の時点で英語も日本語もどっちもペラペラだった。
I think 日本語の方が better, I think.
そっち、その時は？
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, I assume so. He's taking classes in Japanese, right?
まあ、そうか。
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, basically, Japanese is your first native tongue.
I think so. Yeah, technically, first language, as in first learned, is probably Japanese. And then, when we moved to Canada, it kind of switched around, right? You know, no longer in a Japanese environment, so you lose that ability to speak Japanese, right? And so,
did your parents not make you go to Kumon?
My mom threatened me several times to go to Kumon because like, my grades were bad in Canada. Like, if your grades keep getting worse, I'm going to send you to Kumon.
Yeah, we got it. With that weird, I don't know, is that, what emotion
it's,
is
yeah,
that face?
It's just like flummoxed.
it feel good to go and look at that
it's
face.
It's like, oh. I guess like, up until around this time, because Japan was normal for me, it was just like, the concept of Japan didn't really occur to me. Japan was just life, just normal life for me.
まあ、好き嫌いとかいうよりも、これは人生とか。
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because if you stay in one place the whole time, that's just normal for you, right? So, it's not 100, it's definitely not 0, so just kind of, futsu, I guess, right? And so,
I feel like he's like, Nissan no yana, どうだった? Baboom!
But then, like, around here, like, at 7 years old, we moved to Canada.
Mm.
And then, I have very distinct memories of, like, after the first 2 years of being in Canada, I had this idea of, like, I want to go back home to Japan. Because, like, to me, Japan was home for me, right? And I talked to my sisters about this, that, you know, our time in Kobe and Port Island was, like, easily the best time of our childhood. Right?
Way.
Yeah, it was, like, the most fun. Our friends were great, the school we went to was really good, we had great teachers, we lived in a really nice community, and there was no snow. Canada's really snowy and cold and horrible. And Kobe isn't like that. And so I remember like walking home from my elementary school in Canada, thinking, this sucks so bad. I hate Canada. Let's go back to Japan, please. And then I remember like telling my mom, like, can we go back? And she's like, no.
And that's where it began.
Yeah. Well, I mean, she wasn't like, no, but like I think my parents kind of made a decision, like, this is where we're going to stay from now on. So that was a bit disappointing, but I do remember thinking, like, I want to go home. You know, Japan was, well, specifically Kobe was home for me. And so, yeah, that's kind of where this is 100%, right? Because it's like, I want to go home so bad. I love it so much.
そうか、だから10歳くらいまではもうずっと帰りたくて仕方がなかった。
Yeah. And so, and like, it was around this time where I kind of saw myself as like, you know, you move to Canada from Japan, and people say, oh, you're Aaron from Japan. And I'm like, yeah, I am. And so I think that kind of like, you know, Japanese identity kind of like, what, katamatte kita or something like that.
Oh,
it's
I
like,
see.
Like, oh, maybe I am a Japanese guy kind of thing. And at that time, I was a bit more darker skinned, my hair was a certain way, and, yeah, I felt a lot more Japanese than I did white, that's for sure.
Describe your hairstyle at that time. It was still a bowl?
Oh yeah, dude.
Oh, it was still a big bowl?
I was rocking the bowl for many years, man. Yeah,
Aaron from Japan. Not Mr. Fuji from Japan. Aaron from Japan.
Yeah, yeah. You're that Japanese boy, aren't you? Yeah, I guess so.
その10歳くらいの時は、まだ超アジア人って感じなんだ。
I think so, yeah, yeah.
今よりもね。
Yeah. You know, you spend a few years in Canada, and then you get used to it. You get used to life there, and then you kind of see yourself like, well, Canada is a multicultural country, right? Like America.
Yep.
And you see lots of other Asians there. You see lots of other ethnicities. And so you kind of see yourself, well, maybe I'm not just Japanese. Maybe being Canadian doesn't mean white. It can mean a lot of different things. And so...
Good for you.
And so, but because I still had this memory of like being in Japan, born in Japan, speaking Japanese fluently, it kind of was like, well, now I'm here and I'm not exactly Canadian, but I'm not exactly fully Japanese either. And so I think that around this time was when like I was like, oh my god, what am I?
Right? Is this high school? This is like high school,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, around high school, yeah. And so I don't want to make it seem like, oh, I'm so upset, I'm so sad, I'm such a victim or whatever. That's not what I'm trying to say.
But this is your emo phase, right?
It is my emo phase.
So that's exactly
what you're thinking. Yeah. but I don't want to make that real though, you know? So I guess what I'm trying to say is that like the hafu experience can only really be understood by other hafu people, I guess, truly. And so like maybe like Big Bai, maybe you don't understand being Filipino in a white America, let's say, for example.
Right.
Kind of like minority-ish status type of thing.
I mean, I think that we feel the same way. A lot of American Filipinos are not considered Filipinos Filipinos that live in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, if you don't even go out of your way to learn our mother tongue, are you really Filipino?
Exactly.
Like,
yeah.
I've been called white several times,
yeah,
even when I look like this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's like, you're so white. I've been told that by many Filipinos before.
Like the whitewash concept.
Yeah, you're like, not even whitewash, you're just white because you live in America, so you're not even Filipino.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I kind of feel for you that way, so that's why I went to Japan instead, so I wouldn't be ridiculed by my own people.
Yeah.
Byron のお父さんとお母さんはフィリピン人。
Yeah.
で、お父さんとお母さんがアメリカに移住したよね。
Yes.
で、そこでできた子供がバイロンだから、まあ、バイロンはアメリカ人だけど、両親はどっちもフィリピン人。
Correct. Now let's go back to Aaron, because it's not him.
I was trying to put spread that.
まあこれ日本人的な考えなんかな、子供の時って人と違うのめちゃくちゃ嫌なの。
逆 Because like in Japan, you have to be the same as everyone.
そうそう
in certain degree. I feel like high school is the time where in Western countries is all about you wanna be different from everyone else.
Yeah, yeah.
でもさ、そのアーロンは7歳まで日本にいるわけじゃん。だから日本人的なイメージが残ってるのか、
right,
だからどっちなんかなと思って。
Ah, yeah, yeah. Well, I think, you know, I feel like my sister, who was 13 when she left, probably have a different opinion about this, but, you know, being in Japan till 7 isn't a whole lot of time, but that's a pretty formative time of your life, right? You know,
yes.
Your very first memories of you, you know, playing baseball with your friends or something like that in the park, or like making, what's it called?
Baseballs?
No, like dango with the dirt.
Oh!
I give yochien, like I remember doing that with my friends and like, and playing, you know, onigoko, or like walking the f***ing, what it was called, stilts.
For
doing like the undokai and a lot of stuff.
That's cool.
So like those memories are still there, right? And so like when I went to Canada, it just kind of felt like, I'm not used to this, this feels kind of weird.
What's tag?
Yeah. That's tag. Yeah. And I had a very, oh, that's the other thing. I had a very weird accent too. Like, I spoke English in a very, like, strange way. My dad, he's from British Columbia, which is the most western province in Canada. And they have their own unique accent.
Oh, no!
Right?
Oh,
and so,
God!
And then we moved to Ontario, which is, you know, the most populous province. And so, but, you know, not only did I have this like weird BC, British Columbia English accent, but I had like had a bit of like a Japanese accent too, I think. And so,
can you try to give us your best sample of how that sounded like?
Okay, like for example, I would say my A is really like weird. I think I remember my friend being like, "That's not how you pronounce hand." But I would say things like sandwich.
Oh,
like it's really minor.
Sandwich.
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 Sandwich が普通で。
Sandwich, yeah.
Sandwich. 今のは
Sandwich.
Sandwich. 日本語っぽいちょっと発音に似てるんだよね。
Yeah. And then like other words like pattern, like the earn, RN sound, I couldn't do it. I would say pattern.
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 I would try to like katakanaize it.
Yeah.
Pattern. Pattern.
Pattern.
Pattern. Oh, pattern.
Oh. So that was in Japan, right?
Yeah. I think so. Because, so like when I moved to Canada, people like, you're weird. Like, what is this? What's happening here?
Yeah. お父さんの出身もそのブリティッシュコロンビア、
yeah, yeah, yeah.
でちょっと方言っぽいところだったし、
yeah, yeah.
そもそも日本で英語を覚えてるから完璧に発音できなくて、
yeah, yeah.
オンタリオに引っ越した時はちょっと言葉がちゃんと喋れないなってのはあったよね。
Yeah, and like obviously everything is in English, and I was at the bottom of my class when it came to reading, writing.
そうよね。
Yeah, yeah, everything was so difficult, I remember, and I feltso bad. I felt like such a failure because I was like doing so badly, but yeah, you know, because you're a little kid, you're sensitive, right, to these things. And so
right.
I just remember the first few years were pretty tough transition. I remember. Yeah.
それ何歳くらいまでしんどかった?
Probably around like, yeah, probably like end of elementary school, like junior
high. ああ、でもそこら辺ではもう追いつけてみたいな感じ。
Yeah.
で、さっきの話にちょっと戻るけど、この自分って何なんだろうみたいな悩むあるじゃん、この高校生くらいの時。
Yeah.
その時に、まあさっきアナは言ったけど、日本人は他の人と一緒でいたい。みんなと一緒でいたい。で、ヨーロッパ人はってくくっていいのか分かんないけど、私は他の人と違う感じでありたい、異なりたいってあるじゃん。この時どうだったの？あるの？
Okay, well, I think, I don't know what it's like in American schools, but I think Canada and Japan are similar in this one sense, where you want to be the same regardless of what age you are. You want to fit in, right? And so, I think that's especially noticeable during high school, because, like, you don't want to be the weirdo. You don't want to be, like, that one, like...non-white kid, you know what I mean?
Oh.
You know, I also think that, you know, because Canada and America are multiracial societies, whether you want to believe it or not, I feel like being white is kind of like the standard, is like the normal thing.
そうなんや。
So, yeah. And so if you're not white, you're kind of abnormal. I don't want to say abnormal, maybe that's a bit isugi, but like it's you're identified by your race before you are your name, let's say.
Correct.
You know what I mean? So like, oh, you know Byron, that Filipino guy.
Yes.
Or,
そんな言われる。なんて言われてた。
Oh, you're like that Japanese boy, aren't you? You're from the island, aren't you?
So that, I
know. You're the sushi guy.
Sushi guy.
Do you eat sushi every day? It's like, man, what do you mean? Like,
そう、でもそれ相手からしたら別に悪気があって言ってるわけじゃない時もあるよね、きっと。
Yeah.
まあ、本当に意地悪で言ってる時も多分あると思うけど。
Right.
それもうどうしようもないね。
Yeah.
I should have said that to Fuji when I first met him.
Do you eat sushi every day?
You do, don't you?
Sushi も言ってますよ。皆さん、外国人の友達の作り方知りたくないですか？今日は外国人の友達が言語学習を通じて作れるアプリ、ハロートークの紹介になります。
Oh my gosh! Wow! I can't believe we're gonna collab with these guys.
It's amazing.
Yeah, actually, thanks to this app, that's how me and Fuji met for the first time.
No way!
懐かしいね。
懐かしいね。
ハロートークはね、個人的にずーっと使ってきたアプリだったから、今回このコラボのね話いただけて本当に嬉しいです。ありがとうございます。しかもこのチャンネル見てる視聴者には必ず刺さる内容だと思うので、飛ばさずにここはね本当に見てほしいです。アナも使ったことある？
あるよ、うん、あ、じゃあ私からそのハロートークの機能を説明しますね。ハロートークは世界中にユーザーがいて、登録するときに自分が学びたい勉強したい言語と話せる言語を登録できる。で、同じように自分の言語を勉強したい人と交流できるようになってる。
つまり僕が話せる、まあ、母国語は日本語、勉強したい言語は英語ってやった時にアーロンは逆だったよ、うん、だからこういう感じでこのマッチングの一覧にアーロンがポンって出てきて、そこで、友達になって話したりすることができるってことなんだよね。でこれこんな感じでやっぱ一覧出てくるよね。
So of course you can help others learn languages, but you can also make some genuine friends as well、
それに僕がこのアプリがすごいと思うのは、言語をチャットしながら教え合うときに相手や自分のチャットを翻訳できるでしょ。
ああできる、
便利やなそれ。
やね。
So you can obviously you can study while talking to people, but the app has a built-in translator and a dictionary, so it's a really really great study tool.
今日はハロートークさんから提供いただきました。おかげで動画を作ることができました。このアプリを使って海外旅行僕も行くときね、世界中に友達作って現地の人と交流させてもらってるんだよね。そうで、まあその海外旅行行った時も使えるし、今僕ら大阪いるけど、こうやって、まあ、一生の友達アーロンとも知り合うことができました。皆さんも一生の友達を見つけたり、楽しくモチベーションをキープして語学を勉強しましょう。
そしてなんと今なら概要欄のリンクの方から登録すると翻訳機能が無制限になる VIP が2週間無料な特別キャンペーンを今開催してもらってます。
わあ、
上限500人までの制限があるので、まだ登録してない方はぜひ登録してください。
コミュニケーションもしながら語学学習も楽しめるっていうね、まさにね僕らのチャンネルも国際交流
友達を作って楽しむっていうところと語学学習字幕つけてると思いますけど、まあそこも大切にしていくっていうね、この2つで進めてるのがもうすごいね、ハロートークさん一緒なのでマジでおすすめです。
That's right。
ハロートークさんありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。
思春期は辛いね、でもね。
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So like it's, I think it was like during this time where I kind of just kind of came to terms with it. And so this bottom point where the identity crisis peaks, I think I realized like what's the point in being so like, oh, I miss Japan, Canada sucks, I'm not Canadian, I'm Japanese. Because no matter which way I fight it, there's always going to be someone be like, you're not Japanese, you're white. Or you're not white, you're Japanese, right? There's always going to be someone like that around there. So I kind of grew to accept, like, there's no point in fighting it and just accepting who I am for who I am kind of thing. And so, but during this time is when I first thought, maybe I should go back. Maybe I should move back to Japan and see what it's like and to reconnect with my Japanese heritage, just kind of where that came from.
So for you, wow, that was a very good age to realize that too. Yeah, some people do that, like, much later in life.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
you're still,
yeah.
like, torn between these
yeah,
two
yeah.
sides, right?
いや、その時に戻って抱きしめてあげたいよね。
OK、go on the past and do it. 友達もなろうと。僕が
ミスター・フジです。
You are friend of. Get off me, dude.
Get off me. You eat sushi every day.
分かってるから。
But I think one thing I want to point out though is that this line never drops below 50.You know?
嫌いになりそうよね、どう頑張ってもさ、その自分って何なんだろう、なんでこんなアジアンボーイみたいな、いじられるんだろうみたいな思って、ちょっとなんか日本が嫌になりそうだけど、
right, yeah.
でも50は全然切らないんだね。
Right, yeah, it's like the entire time, even when I was having a very difficult time in Canada, I would still think to myself, you know, at least I still have these memories of Japan, and I had family there, I still do have family here, and so we did take a couple family trips to go back to Japan every now and again, that was always great.And so, because I have those positive memories, it was always above 50% kind of thing of I like、
ね、
Japan.
ちょっとここに書いてない話していい？大学は何歳で入るのカナダって
18。
あ、18歳なの、
yeah, yeah.
日本と一緒？小学校が6年間で、中学3年、高校3年。
So, elementary school and junior high school are the same for the most part.
そう、ね、
So, at least in my school it was. So, it was like...1年生から8年生まで。
あ、8年生
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, first grade to eighth grade.、Right?
Yeah,
yeah.
yeah.
あ、そうなの。え、高校がじゃあ4年間って
。Yeah, yeah. 9, 10, 11, 12.
Yeah, 面白い。
Yeah, same, same.
And then university is 4 years.
大学はどこの大学行ったんだっけ
University of Western Ontario.
オンタリオの大学行ったんだ。
そうそう。
大学は何専攻してたの
?History.
なんか関係あるのかなやっぱ、ね、
絶対関係あるでしょ。
そのやっぱね、日本で生まれてカナダに行ってなんかこう歴史みたいなのが。
Yeah, yeah, yeah.、うん、I mean, well, I mean, not even maybe because my interest in history maybe came from me having this half experience. But I always just thought history was interesting because it was like just one big story, right? One long story that everything is kind of connected in some way, and that no single historical event exists in isolation. Everything is connected.Right.
Yeah.
So, a good example is like, you know, say the World Wars, you know, there isn't one single event that made the whole thing happen. It was like a cascading series of events that were linked together to make this big event culminate in this huge explosion of the war, right? And so, it's like things like that, like linking the dots together is what I found really interesting about history. And so, maybe in some ways, I thought, if I can understand Canadian history, if I can understand the history of migration...immigration and the experience of people who came here from other places, maybe I'll have a better idea of understanding myself in some way.
ちょっと泣きそうなんやけど。
Wow, that's cool, man. That's a very good reason to start majoring in something and
yeah,
came
yeah.
to that realization.
Yeah.
Holy crap, dude. What did you go through?
Well, that's what like I said, I don't want this video to be framed as like, oh, I'm so, like,For me, blah, blah, blah. Like, I really don't want that to come across this way. I think what I want to convey is that being multiracial, I suppose, is an experience that isn't easily understood by the people, maybe, let's say. So, like, not, I don't want to say, like, oh, you don't understand, so don't bother trying. I think because it's so complicated, it's hard to describe how you feel.
自分が子供の頃さ、すごいちょっとだけ他の人と違うだけでしんどかった思い出とかあって、家が、まあ、あんまりお金なかったから、で、あの3兄弟、
mm-hmm.
だから絶対に上のお兄ちゃんとかのお下がりのものなんよね、全部ピアニカとか、あの絵の具とか、なんかその裁縫道具とか、全部そうなんよ、
mm-hmm.
で、靴とかも学校が決めたやつじゃなくて、なんかお母さんが、もうこれ履いてったらええやろ、みたいな。白いから。
いやいや。
これ白いから、別にええやろ、なんでもって言われて、そしたら一人だけ違うわけじゃん。
いやいや。
それでも結構嫌だったのよ、なんか。で、それはでもさ、自分自身じゃないじゃん。切り離せるじゃん。
Yeah.
でももう自分から切り離せないじゃん。
その
、ハーフっていうのは。
Yeah, yeah, right.
だから、なんかすごいよね、それをさ、その、前向きに選考とか、そのメジャーをね、自分で選んで、ポジティブに捉えていこうみたいな、すごい素敵だなと思って。
But one thing I want to say about you having, if you had like a different thing compared to other people, it felt bad. I remember like when I first showed up to my elementary school in Canada, I had like the, what, fudebako, like the, like the Japanese ones where it goes up like this, whatever. And everyone had like cool pencil case with like zippers and stuff like that. And I show up with this like Snoopy thing, Snoopy fudebako like this.
Yeah.
And,
引き出しが何個も
ついてる。Yeah, exactly. And all my pencils were lined up like this.
多分分かってないんじゃない。
And like on the other side, there's like your rulers and stuff, right?
Yeah.
And so I remember like showing up, and everyone was like had these like huge pencil cases and and I write with that. And I just remember being like, man, this really is different. And
それはポジティブだった、ネガティブだった。
Well, I think at the time it was just like, what the hell? Like I was just confused. I think more than anything. Yeah.
そうだね。
But then you know, I think once I started getting attention from other people, it's like, why is your pencil case so different? You know, and like, and food. The other thing is food.
Yeah.
And so like for school lunch, there was no kyushoku, right, in Canada, and so you had to bring your own lunch. And sometimes it would be like, you know, I would have like nori or something like that, or like some Japanese thing.
Oh.
And they'd be like, why are you eating seaweed? That's so gross.
That sucks, dude.
God. But I, you know, if you look this up online, there's, you know, you'll read hundreds of stories of first generation Americans or Canadians having the exact same thing. So it's definitely not unique to me. So.
Right. Yeah, a lot of Asians go through that kind of thing.
その青春時代になんか日本のエンターテインメントのものとか触れてた。例えばバイロンとかアナはもともとアニメがめちゃくちゃ好きで日本に興味持ってみたいな形だったんだけど、アナはなんか好きだったりしたの？
Oh, back in Kobe, I used to watch Ojaru Maru. I would watch like Ojaru Maru and like the original Dragon Ball, original Dragon Ball, and like what else did I watch? Kureno Shinchan とか。Right. And so when we first moved into our house in Ontario,We brought back with us a VHS movie of Kureno Shinchan. Some Kureno Shinchan. I can't remember which one it was, but it was hilarious. And it was like the very first day we moved in, we watched it. And I remember that was like a very like Shinchan in Canada. It was a really weird thing. But I think from then on, I would still try to watch things like Shinchan or like Dragon Ball. I think Dragon Ball became a big thing because my classmates were into Dragon Ball too. And so that was like the one thing that was like, oh, Aaron, maybe you are...cool or something because you watch Dragon Ball in Japan, right? Okay, maybe you can hang out with me.
It's
crazy, yeah. So like my best friend back in school, Eric Yang, he's Chinese Canadian and he's just like jacked. He was jacked when he was in grade 2. He was huge. Just like really muscular in grade 2. And I don't know how. He's just like a stocky guy.
What grade is grade 2?
You're like 10, no, 9.
No, you're, yeah.
You're 9 years old, but he was just like big. He was like a big boy back then. And he liked Dragon Ball. And I remember that was like the one thing that we bonded over. It's like, oh, you like Dragon Ball? Oh, me too. And then that's how we became friends.
Yeah, of course.
Like I said, I don't want this me being half Japanese thing to be like a detriment, a negative thing all the time. Because it certainly benefited me in many ways. You know, making friends and so on. And,making certain friends, let's say.
Oh, did anyone ever do this to you?
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
That's so much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah when my Japanese identity became most salient to me, I was at a church. We used to go to church a lot in Canada. And this church that we went to was shared between a, you know, a regular mainstream white Canadian congregation, mm-hmm. which I was a part of.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was a Korean congregation. Okay. So we shared the same building, right? But the Korean congregation was, this Korean service was after our service. But there was a lot of overlap between the two. So we got to know each other quite a bit. And there were a lot of boys my age in the Korean group. And I became like kind of friends with them. And then one day I was waiting for my parents to leave to go home. And when like there's a group of five or six of them, they roll up to me and they're Korean. And they started saying things like, your ancestors killed my ancestors during the war.
すげえな.
And I'm like, what? And I'm 10. I don't know anything about the war, right? And they're 10 too, so they clearly didn't look up themselves. They were told this by their parents or something. And they were like, and they like pushed me to the ground.
Huh?
And they like started like yelling all this shit to me. And I was like, what is happening? And I remember going, look, I'm Asian too. Like I remember saying Asian friendly, come on, what is this? And then that was like, what was that? Because I thought these kids were my friends,
mm-hmm.
right? But then it's like moments like that where it's like, okay, so I'm white, but I'm Japanese in this situation. You know what I mean? It's like you can't choose which one it is, kind of thing. And so
it's the worst.
You're like both and neither at the same time.
Exactly. I think. I think that's the kind of the driving theme over the mixed race experience. You're neither and both at the same time. Yeah, so well put. So. I think I was just confused. It didn't make any sense to me.
Mm.
Okay, so anyway, so I finished university, and then I started thinking maybe I should go back to Japan, and then I eventually do when I'm 25, and I moved to Kagawa of all places.
Nice.
I wanted to go to Kobe because that was like, you know, my hometown, but I go to Kagawa, and it turns out that my koseki is in Kagawa. And so, it was the most gruzen thing there is. And so,
you were called on by your ancestors.
I really was.
Oh my
God,
dude.
It was truly a mad coincidence. Like I said when I was getting hired by this company, I said I want to be in West Japan, preferably around Kansai, right? And they put me in Kagawa, and I was like, that's kind of that's shitty. What the hell? I don't want to be in Kagawa. I want to be in Kobe. And then it wasn't until like after I got there. And I was talking to my aunt, and she's like, oh, like, you know, you're a jichan bachi, you used to live in Utazu. And I'm like, oh, never mind.
Oh my God.
Yeah. And like, and then when they say that, I remember like as a kid going to this shrine, Konpira-san, right? And I remember like walking up those 2,000 steps to get there, to get to the top when I was like 10 or something. And then now I'm here at 25, like, oh yeah, I remember being here 15 years ago. Yeah, it was really, really weird.
That's crazy,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah,
oh
yeah.
My God. It called you back to that shrine.
Exactly,
you
yeah, yeah,
back here.
Yeah. And so when I got back to Kagawa, I was like, oh, I'm back, I'm home. I've returned to the motherland.
Yeah.
And so I finally, you know, arrived to my people again.
どうだった?日本に久しぶりに、まあ、引っ越してきて、懐かしいなって気持ちだったのか、うわ、なんかこんな感じだったっけみたいな感じなのか。
It was a mix of both, I guess. Like, I remember like going to konbini and hearing like smelling the same smells. Like, that stays with you. Like, I'm like, all Lawsons smell the same.
どういうこと?
For some reason.
I think I know what you mean.
Do you know what I mean? It's like, it's
日本のってことね。
Yeah, 日本の Lawson, ね。And when I went back to the Lawson for the first time as an adult, I'm like, oh yeah, this is what it smells like. Or like, in this, because I came back in March of 2018, and it was like springtime-ish, mm-hmm. right? And I remember the same smells. I feel like the smell was the main thing that stuck with me. Like, it smelled the same, and like, the sounds were the same. It may have looked different. Everything seemed a bit smaller than what I remember, but yeah, everything just kind of came back to me suddenly. It was really weird.
20 年の時を経て、ローソン、ウィーンって開きました。帰ってきたぞ!
Yeah. Because like a lot of, like what me and my sister used to do, like when we were living in Kobe, there's a Lawson on the very, very bottom floor. And so we'd always go down there and buy papiko or haichu. And so when I went back to the Lawson first time, like, oh my God, this is, I've returned. You know, that was the thing that I, you know, remember the most.
日本に帰ってきて、英語の先生し始めた。
Yeah. I did that for 3 years in Kagawa. And it was great. It was awesome because I was working in elementary schools and I remember thinking, oh yeah, this is what it looks like. You know, I was reminded of like, you know, the shoes box and then the pencil cases and I remember like seeing all these things that I remember using as a kid and I was like, oh, natsukashi, suge, or whatever, right? And then that was really cool. But at that time though, like my Japanese was terrible. Like I could hardly string together a sentence. But I just remember, for some reason, words like honma and like nayane or something like that stuck with me. and I always thought that Kansai Ben was just standard Japanese. That was and so like I remember like meeting my vice principal for the first time at the school, and he said something to me. I could understand Japanese okay at that point, but and he like said something to me. I'm like, oh, homa or something, and he laughed. He's like, why is this white face saying homa to me for the very first time? And I'm like, and the concept of like rude versus polite Japanese or whatever just didn't exist for me.
That's right, because you only spoke to your mom, right?
Yeah, I went to my friends when I was seven, you know? So,
right.
Yeah, so like there were so many things that were kind of funny about the whole experience because I was breaking every single rule, you know. I did 3 years in Kagawa, and then I moved to Osaka to do a similar job, teach English. But I think at that time I was starting to get kind of like, you know, I'm approaching 30 years old, I'm past 25, I should probably figure out what I want to do with my life. And I started to get the career anxiety, I suppose. And then, so I was kind of frantically like kind of looking around for options.
Yeah. I remember that time.
確かにこれ日本人全然知らないと思うんだけど、まあ英語ネイティブの国から来た外国人の人の仕事が英語の先生しかない、
yeah.
めっちゃしんどいってよく言う、みんながよく言ってて、なんでかっていうと、まあ、英語の先生につくのは簡単に見つかるけど、それ以外に転職しようとしてもなんかすごいハードルが高くてみんな受け入れてくれないっていうのを本当みんな言ってるよね。で、大体国に帰る人は他に英語の先生以外の仕事が見つからないからもうちょっと無理だっつって日本から帰ってくる人多いから、なんかそこはね、絶対直した方がいいなって思ってるけど、まあそれでちょっと嫌になってきたと。
Yeah, 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 yeah. And so, I mean, I had ambitions of doing a PhD in history, and so I did want to go back to Canada to do that at some point, or I was even thinking maybe I'll do that in Japan. Pursuing a doctorate degree in history just seems very unstable, you know, like the pay is very...there's no guarantee of a job basically, and so
right.
And so I started studying programming on my own, web development, web programming,
yeah.
And then I got a job last year doing web programming. Yeah.
これねめちゃくちゃすごいことなんやな。本当にみんなに伝えた。すごいことです。
Yeah, but anyway, so but the reason why it dipped so low, even though I got this job, is I'm not used to the work hours. that's the thing that it will take some getting used to. I did work a little bit in Canada at a bank, but the hours were pretty rigid. They were pretty strict. You did your 8 hours and you left, for sure. And the work was pretty easy. But now it's like, I'm A, dealing with a Japanese company, all in Japanese. Meetings are in Japanese. Messages are in Japanese. I'm, of course, the Japanese company. The programming itself is fine. It can be challenging, but...I think it's like the culture and the things that aren't being said is that what I find particularly difficult right now. So, but it's, I'm getting used to it, so that's...
もういつまでもポジティブで優しい。もうずっと文句言うわ、僕だったら。どういうことこれ、つって。あのね、もうめっちゃ残業してて、だってこの前、何時まで働いてた
like, 終電。
終電でしょ、そう、週何回か終電があったよね。
Yeah, 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 yeah.
めっちゃ聞いてて大変そうだなって。
And now we're here. So, yes.
I have a question.、
Yeah.
So, this Aaron right now,、mm-hmm. that's right here,、
mm-hmm.
experiencing a very larger than, I would say, 75% happy in Japan.、
Mm-hmm.
What would you tell this guy right there?
Oh.
Yeah, what would you say to that guy? Let's say, like, you could just go there right now, and this is, like, the lowest point in your life.
Man.
What would you say to that guy?
Deep question, man.
Yeah.
過去の自分に言うってこと?
The right now, what would you say to this person.
Ah, wow, なんかバイオめちゃくちゃいいこと言うな。
いいですね、いいですね。
I wanted to ask, but then I felt like it was more appropriate to ask at the end.
Good question, man.
Yeah.
I think just relax. It's gonna be okay. Because I think not only like, because this, especially around here, around 20, 25, like you finish school, you don't know what you're gonna do with your life. And it's really easy to have a huge amount of anxiety about like, am I gonna be able to afford to live? Where am I gonna get a job? What am I gonna do? Is any place gonna hire me? But I think now it's on the up, right?
Yeah.
I think I've reached a point in my situation where I feel pretty stable. You know, I have a full-time job, I have an apartment that I like, and I have a routine that I think is sustainable, and I have good hobbies and stuff like that. And so, because I have this now, even though I went through a particularly low point, I think I want to just tell this person, it's going to be okay. You know,
yeah.
you don't have to worry about these things. The things that you're worrying about now, it will pass, I guess. I mean, that's a pretty cop-out answer, but...
No, I mean, that makes sense. I feel like these guys don't have to worry about taxes. People destroying your life, or you don't have to worry about like these trivial things anymore at this age, because we have to worry about going home before shuden.
It
means to work past shuden.
This
guy definitely knows, which are the problems of today. Respect to that, you know, those problems are they're problems, but you know, it's different perspectives because of different ages, right?
So anyway,
めちゃくちゃいい話ですね。はい、ということで今日はアーロンの人生について話してみました。
どうだった？
It was very interesting because like for me the concept coming from Romania, which is also kind of similar to Japan in the sense that it's a very homogeneous society, it's a very interesting perspective that I would never hearfrom someone close to me back in like middle school or elementary school. So yeah, it was very insightful.
It's really interesting because, man, we should have been friends like earlier, bro, because the first time I had I think an exposure to a Japanese person who brought rice balls with nori to school, I was eating like, I don't know, chicken or something like that, and then it looked weird to me, like rice ballsand nori and like a bunch of salmon, and I was like, what is that? He's like, rice balls and seaweed. I'm like, oh cool. And I just didn't think anything because you know, it's not weird to have sustenance, right? And that's I was taught that at an early age, right? So I feel like with mine, like I did the total opposite. So I would avoid people who categorized me as that Asian kid, and instead just hung out with Asians. So I tried to like seclude myself from all like the segregation. So it was interesting to see that, you know, you went through like a lot of kudo because people were defining you as like this Japanese kid, right? As you were young. And then it's really cool to see like how you've really matured throughout like all the years. And I think that this was a very pivotal point in your life that got you to where you are now, right? So I mean, you've said bits and pieces on the channel about your whole life, but now that we know like the whole story, it just gives me a newfound appreciation for you, bro.
Oh, thanks, buddy.
Yeah, man. It's good to know you and be your friend, man.
Oh, thanks.
That's
really
how that's how I feel.
Thanks, man.
I'm glad we're friends now. I would have said, yo, can I have one, bro?
Yeah.
Sauce me in onigiri.
Sauce me in onigiri. I got you, buddy. I'll sauce
you. Yeah, dude.
まあ僕のね考えなんだけど。辛い思いとか傷つけば傷つくほど人は優しくなれるんじゃないかなと思ってて、だからアーロンは結構まあ過去にいろいろあって、もうどう考えてもこのメンバーの中で一番優しいじゃん。でなんか今日なんか今日その理由がすごい分かったなと思うし、でも傷ついたけどそれをポジティブに捉えて歴史勉強しようとか日本に行ってみようとか、なんか常にやり続ける。まあ、今バンドとかめっちゃやってるじゃん。英語の先生だけじゃなくて、じゃあそのジョブチェンジするためには勉強しようとか、なんか前に進み続けるアーロンがもうすごい素敵だなと思うし、これからも友達でありたいと思いました。
お願いします。
はい。
Thanks, Anna.
Thanks, Anna. You're the best, Anna.
You're the best, yeah. No, I really appreciate you guys. Thanks for...
Yeah, man. We appreciate you too.
Yeah, thanks, buddy.
Yes.
はい、I like how you just combine the handshake and the Japanese.
Oh, yeah,
exactly. さすがエレン。
さすが、yeah.
さすがエレン。
はい。皆さんは今日のアーロンの人生の話を聞いてどう思ったでしょうか。ぜひ感想をコメント欄までよろしくお願いします。
全部読んであげるから。
I will read it to Aaron because Aaron will go like ooh, and we'll be probably too embarrassed to read the comments, so I'll read it to him for you guys.
Thanks, man.
Yes.
他に僕らにトークしてほしい話があればコメント欄までよろしくお願いします。それでは次の動画でまたお会いしましょう。
バイバイ。
ちゃん、
寝る。
登録
お願いします。